So I'm starting here at a special effects build shop called Stunt Ranch, just outside of Austin, Texas.
Hey, here he is.
With the help of Lee Trebosik, a world-class illusionist and escape artist, and Steve Wolf, the special effects and stunt designer who owns this facility, we'll solve the riddles of the engineering genius behind Houdini's greatest spectacles. Reconstructing my great uncle's water torture cell is a natural first step. What kind of skills would he have needed to perform this classic feat? And would they have been used for any other purpose beyond a performance?
When he performed it, his legs were shackled into the stocks, and then a pulley lifted him upside down, and then he took his final big breath, and then, of course, they lowered him down, and once he was underwater, they would put a screen up to shield him from the audience.
And he would stay in the tank for 30, 40, 50 minutes, an hour.
We still have to figure out how he was able to hold his breath.
And then at exactly the right time, boom, right, he pops out.
The standing ovation.
Essentially, we're gonna be building a big fish tank.
Mm-hmm.
We'll use some steel angle iron for these pieces here and weld them together. And then we'll put in our, you know, our glass plates here.
Now the top was lowered down from a pulley. Now the holes up top for the stocks.
Do we know their shape?
We can't tell what the shape of the hole underneath it was.
We actually don't have any physical evidence of how the mechanism inside it worked. So we're gonna have to figure that out.
All right.
I've held off on building the final tank until Lee's had a chance to work in the practice chamber and realize just how small it is. When you see it in pictures, movies, or posters, it feels like an enormous box. But when you're inside it, it feels like a water-filled coffin. And that's exactly what Houdini intended.
Hey, how are you doing there?
We knew that building the box was going to be the easy part once we had the measurements. It was just a matter of fabricating some acrylic and steel to a design spec.
Jump in there, Selena. Oh. Okay.
Oh. Ta-da! So,
here we go.
This is finally it. I'm going to get to see Lee perform the trick that my great uncle started doing more than 100 years ago.
You guys ready?
We are.
Yes.
How are you doing,
yes.
Thanks.
All right.
Good. Feeling good?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, this is it. I'm doing this for the first time in the stocks with water in the tank.
Ready?
Here we go. All right, we're gonna pull the stocks. Lift this side with me.
Got it.
Good. As I'm locking Lee into the stocks, I can only hope that I've gotten every part of the design right, because everything depends on it working under pressure. Your feet go in. I'm gonna set this, and we are going to lock you in. You are locked in.
Feeling those locks vibrate was very intimidating.
Take me up.
Begin the lift, and continue the lift. Good. Feeling all right?
Yeah.
All right, remember to tuck, lift, lift. Good. Are you locked in well there, Lee?
Yeah.
Make sure his head clears nicely. Lift, lift, lift. One more. Good. Moving over, transition, head space. Good.
I've dreamed of attempting this escape since I was 10. But right now, it's about staying focused and keeping the excitement and stress out of my mind. I need to concentrate if I'm gonna be able to hold my breath long enough to make this escape.
Bring me down just a little bit.
Down a little bit. Hold.
When I'm hanging over that tank, taking my last breath, it's incredibly lonely and silent.
Three, two, one.
For your arms, lower. Guiding, guiding, guiding. Continue down, continue down, continue down. Lid is on, he's in position. Curtain.
When Houdini performed the escape, he would build tension by staying behind the curtain for over an hour, letting the audience think he was still in the cell. they would be out of their minds by the time he revealed himself. We just passed the longest time Lee was able to stay under during practice.
He's in there a long time.
Put her there.
Good job, man.
Wow, how was it?
It was a lot of work.
Yeah?
You did great.
How did you get out?
I ain't telling.
What's the trick?
Magicians might not reveal their tricks, but let me tell you how we pulled off our version of the water torture cell escape. We had to divide this performance into things that the audience could see from things that the audience couldn't see.
Then down, 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 down.
In Houdini's time, the audience definitely would have been fooled. No one had ever seen a feat performed like this before. Lee is lowered in. We make sure that the stocks are securely on top of the box. Once he hits that spot, the curtain comes up, and now we're able to play with the secret gadgetry inside. What we did is we pulled retaining pins that allowed the shelf that is holding the ankle restraints to separate. Once they separate, Lee can simply slip out, make his turn, and climb up. He then pushes the shelves the rest of the way open and climbs out on top of the tank.
It's an amazing feeling to be able to reconstruct one of Houdini's most iconic escapes. Recreating this escape has not only given me a profound new respect for Harry Houdini, but has also inspired me to add deeper complexities, both physical and mental, to my own performances.
I really think that walking in my great uncle's footsteps this way is the only path to find the truth. In just 1 week, we've discovered the secret to his water torture stocks, locked in on how he trained his body, and are closer to solving the mysteries that defined his career.